I know how exciting it can be to welcome your new baby home, and but also feel like you are staring at a stranger. Number one, kudos to you if you're actually looking to do activities with your 0 to 3 month old, because that fourth trimester is sometimes exhausting and not always the easiest. But the good thing is these are all really small activities that will definitely engage active awake time to hopefully get a little bit better sleep. If they don't work, if your baby cries, there's nothing wrong with you. You're not doing anything wrong. Sometimes babies just are going through it. Just want to throw that out there. If you guys are new here, my name is Rachel from The Confused Mom. I have loads and loads of toddler activities for all the different holidays and seasons. I also have tons of buying guides and gift guides, Love Every Playcare reviews, Monty Kids reviews. So I will leave links to all of those in the description box below. Make sure to hit that notification and subscribe button so you don't miss future videos. This is my little guy, Captain. He is 3.5 months old now. Okay, so number one is just gonna be talking with your baby, narrating what you're doing, what's going on, singing to them, tickling them, any way that you can use your voice. I know Love Every encourages speaking in a sing-songy voice. More Montessori approaches encourage speaking to your baby as if you would talk to any other adult. Pros and cons to both of those. Babies tend to pick up and engage with sing-songy voices. Others encourage no baby talks. So really just do whatever is right for your family, because there's always going to be conflicting information out there when it comes to baby development. And it's always about figuring out what is safest and best for you and your family. Next thing that you can do is just lots and lots of skin-to-skin time. Part of the reason why there's not a ton of videos of me with my babies in those first few months is we're all basically naked between breastfeeding. And I just find that skin-to-skin is typically be your best bet at regulating them. Not only their temperature in those first few days before they can regulate their own temperature, but also their emotions as the weeks unfold. And that's a good tip, even like as they get older. I know as they get older and we start to put them in clothes more often, it can be hard to remember that skin to skin is still really effective. So whether they're teething, going through a leap, anything like that, skin to skin is always really good to have in your toolbox. And if you do choose to nurse, it is also a really good way to keep your milk supply up and boosted. Of course, it's not foolproof. The next little tip is going to be bilateral movements. And basically what this is you're reaching the opposite arm to the opposite foot, working with your baby. So if they're resisting it, don't force them, but really just kind of doing this cross-body bilateral movement helps connect the opposite sides of the brain. It's also a nice way to get a nice side body stretch, especially in these 0 to 3 months when they're so used to being kind of bunched up in a ball from the womb. It's allowing them and encouraging them to stretch out their body is really good. It's just a really fun activity to do. I find my kids really like it. Even my toddler wants me to do it to her. And I usually do about 10 on each side, a couple times a day. And the next one is going to be all about winding your baby. So helping them pass gas and go to the bathroom. Probably heard of bicycle kicks, as well as moving your hand. I think it's clockwise. It might be counterclockwise around their belly. However, that is actually not the best way to wind your baby. Instead, I had come across this video from a pediatric OT, which basically has you do a figure eight or an infinity symbol with their hips. And the idea here is to open up that side body, maneuver their hips in a way that is going to create space for things to move down. So it's less likely to come back up on you. Babies tend to kind of clench all of that back in and shorten things because it's just what they're used to. And we would do that after each feeding. The next little thing that you can do is give them a tour of the house. Walk them through the different items in the cabinets, the different rooms, all that type of stuff. Our babies sleep in our room the first couple months and then we move them into their rooms. And I usually walk them into their room and say, this is where you're gonna be sleeping, and just talking to them. Do they understand it? I have no idea. Have the transitions to their own rooms been easy? Yes, they have. So little things like that can be helpful. It's a good habit to be in to let them know what they can anticipate, because as they become toddlers, they really enjoy a sense of order. So regardless if they understand it or not, in these first few months, it is a strong foundational parenting hack for you in those future months. Other things you can do at this stage are to dance with your baby around the house, giving them lots and lots of eye contact. It's not only good for you postpartum and getting happy hormones going, it's also really good for them with bonding. And on that kind of note too, with visual development, this first couple months of life, babies only see in that black and white high contrast. So giving them something like the Munari Mobile or high contrast flashcards are all great options for active awake time and stimulating their brain. Don't be afraid to take your baby outside. It could be as easy as just going for a walk outside in the backyard, looking at the trees. This little guy went to the beach for the first time, I think at 2 weeks. My daughter was the first time at 12 days. Just practice safe sun exposure. What my midwife said, especially in those early days when jaundice is still a concern, she just had to lay him in front of a window that gets indirect sunlight for about 20 minutes a day. So little things like that end up going a really long way. The other thing that you can do is imitate them. If they make a sound, do something with their face, you can go ahead and just copy them. This is gonna lay the foundation for early conversational skills. And of course, reading is another great thing to do, even at this young of an age, whether that is just books with high contrast images or actual books with words. My suggestion would just be, and you probably intuitively do this, is stay on the page until the baby looks away from the page. It really helps encourage a deeper concentration and sets up, in my opinion, a nice foundation for the future of independent play, which I will leave a link to that full post in the description box as well. And make sure to hit that notification and subscribe button so you don't miss more videos, all the activities to do with your babies. And in the meantime, feel free to go ahead and check out our Montessori at Home series. Feel free to check out my past Love Every Play Kit reviews. I do talk about some activities that you guys can do in those as well, not just a play kit review. And until next time, have a good one.